With the removal of the skeleton modification stack from Godot 4.0, I've received a few requests to update my tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create an improved procedurally animated spider bot that is fully controllable and can walk on rough terrain, walls and ceilings. The first step is to have a model that's been rigged. I'm using this quick one that I threw together in Blender. If you want to follow along with the video, I'll put a download link for the model in the description. Now in Godot, I've created a simple room in the main scene using CSG nodes. I'm now creating an inherited scene from the Blender model and updating the material so it looks a little nicer. Now let's get to the IK setup. As I mentioned in the intro, the skeleton modification stack is removed from 4.0. Either they'll re-add an improved implementation in a later version, or we'll get something new entirely. For now though, we need to use the deprecated skeleton IK3D node. Add 4 skeleton IK3D nodes to the skeleton node, one for each leg in our robot, and set up the chain. There's a strange behaviour where only the bone before the tip bone will point at the target, but in our case we actually want the last bone in the chain to do that. To work around this, I added an extra bone at the end of the bot's legs in Blender that has zero weighting for mesh deformation, and set that as the tip bone in Godot. The root bone is the third bone up from our tip. We also want to use a magnet force with a value set to 10 on the y-axis to keep our legs pointing upwards. Set this up for each leg. Now let's set up 4 nodes to act as our IK targets. I'm using markers to make them visible in the editor. Adjust their position until you're happy with the default pose. We need to attach a script to our IK nodes to start the IK simulation when the game is started. We can add tool to this script so the IK runs in the editor too, which makes finding the right positions for our targets easier. Get the targets into a place you're happy with. At the moment, if we move the scene's root node, the IK targets will move too. We can set the transform to top level so they will ignore the parent's movement when the game is running. Let's add a script to our robot so we can move around. Attach a script and at the top export 2 variables to hold the move speed and turn speed. Then in process, let's get our input directions and translate and rotate accordingly. You may wonder why I'm using rotate object local instead of rotate Y. Using rotate object local like this means we're always rotating around the object's local y-axis, regardless of its global orientation. This means it will work while we're standing on a wall or upside down. Now let's add our bot to the main scene and try it out. To handle walking, our IK target is going to track its distance to a step target. Unlike our IK target, this step target node will not be top level, so it will move along with our spider. If the distance gets too far, we'll move our IK target to the step target's position. Let's begin by setting up our step targets. First, I'm going to add a node 3D called step target container, which we'll need for later. To make things quicker, I'm copying the IK target nodes, removing top level and renaming them to step target. We want our step targets to always align with the floor, so I'm then positioning raycast nodes at the step targets, angling them slightly and moving them up. The angle helps when attempting to walk up 90 degree surfaces. To position our step targets to the floor, create a new script and attach it to the rays. Get a reference to our step target node, and then in the physics process, if a hit point is found, move the target position to the hit location. Then, in the editor, set the step target references. Now attach a script to our IK targets. This script will handle animating the target. At the top, add 2 variables. One is a reference to our step target node, and the other is our distance before taking a step. Then, add a new function called step. Like before, we're going to use tweening to animate the target. This is a tweening logic from the old implementation. It was overly complicated and only lifted the leg upwards globally on the y-axis, which ruins the effect when you're walking up vertical inclines or upside down. I've now simplified the tween to this. We get our target position and then find the halfway point between it and our current location. Then we tween to the halfway point plus our owner's, which is the spider bot's, basis.y. This will be 1 meter up in whichever direction the spider is currently oriented. Once we reach the target, we then tween to the final target position. Finally, in process, check the distance between the target and our current position, and if we exceed our required value, call step. Let's see how that looks. Well, it works, but all our legs are stepping at the same time. Let's make it so we can't step if the adjacent leg on the left or right is already stepping. Back in our script, add a reference to our adjacent leg and a boolean to track if we're currently in the stepping state. Then add to our if statement to only step if 1, we aren't already stepping, and 2, if the adjacent leg isn't stepping. Then, in the step function, set isStepping to true. Then let's add a callback tween to the end of our tween queue. For the callback, we're going to use a lambda function to set isStepping back to false after the step is complete. Set the adjacent references and let's take another look. Ah, that's much better. But personally, I like it when the legs diagonally step at the same time. If you want to implement that too, let's add another reference to our diagonally opposite leg, and then when we call step on the opposite leg too. Much better. This looks great while turning around, but while we're walking, the legs lag behind a bit. Let's fix that now. Add a new script to our step container. Add a variable to the top and store our desired offset when moving. Let's also grab a reference to our parent node and store the parent's previous position. Then, in process, we can calculate the velocity by subtracting the previous position from our parent's current position. We can then set our container's position using this velocity multiplied by our offset. Finally, update the previous position variable. This is looking way better. We just need to get our body moving and rotating based on the leg positions now. Back in our main SpiderBot script, let's first move our movement logic into another function for neatness. Then, let's add some references to the top to hold our legs' IK targets. Let's also create a variable to hold our desired height offset from the ground. In the old video, I used the following logic to handle the rotation, taking the average leg positions and using the difference to calculate rotations on the relevant axis. This method works great until you go upside down or vertical, and then it quickly falls apart. I had to come up with a solution that would work for any orientation, and that's when I remembered my old friend the plane class. A plane is essentially a position and a direction, also known as a normal, that has various uses. One way we can initialize a plane is by putting in three positions in a clockwise order. My idea was to create two planes from the IK target positions, then we can average the normal to get our body's desired orientation. We just then need to be able to turn this normal into a transformation basis. We can do this in a similar way to how we did it in the path-based mesh generation video. I'll skip the explanation on bases as I already went over it in that video. Our new basis Y is the normal direction. Its X is the normal crossed with our forward direction, and the Z is the right direction crossed with the normal direction. Finally, let's overwrite our basis with the newly calculated one. We can use lerp2 to make this smoother. Now let's check the results. Awesome, we're almost there. There's just one last thing we need to do. We need to make sure we lift the body up and down based on the height of the IK targets. Let's calculate the average position of the legs, then calculate the target position as this average plus our bot's up direction multiplied by the ground offset. Now we only care about the distance between our current position and the target position in the spider bot's current up direction. We can calculate this by using the always helpful dot product. If we take our direction, call the dot function, and pass in the target position minus our current position, we'll get only the difference for that direction. We can then lerp towards our position plus our up direction multiplied by our calculated distance. This will work no matter which way our spider bot is oriented. And there we have the final result. There's a few things you could do to improve this, but I'll leave that up to your imagination. Anyway, I think that about does it for this video. I hope you found it useful. I'll leave a GitHub link to the finished project in the description below. If you found this video useful, please give it a like and think about subscribing. In the future, if a Godot update has killed this implementation again, let me know and I'll do another updated video. I've recently started streaming my Godot tinkering on Twitch. If you want to see me fumble at both streaming and coding simultaneously, be sure to send me a follow. Anyway, I'll see you in the next one. Cheers!